matchup features a team who likes to get it done through the air. The Saints are number one in total pass yards, going up against the Rams, who will have to be at their best to slow them down. With that, let's hand it over to Brandon Gott and Charles Davis. They've got the call of this Week 12 matchup.
Thank you very much, Larry. As usual, the streets of the nearby French Quarter are alive as we are in downtown New Orleans at the Mercedes-Benz Superdome. Today, it's Week 12 of the NFL season, and we've got a good one in store between the Los Angeles Rams and the New Orleans Saints. Along with Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. And Charles, you look at this Saints team as they interplay. They come in losers of two straight, so they're trying to right the ship here a little bit.
They're teetering a little bit, aren't they? And now things could really go south if they lose this game, so they understand the importance of playing well and stopping this streak.
Meanwhile, for the visiting Rams, they've come in on a nice run of recent form, 4 wins out of 5. Look at the spin. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. And here come the Saints for their opening drive. They're led out by their 6-foot quarterback. You may have heard of him from Purdue. It's Drew Brees.
And when you think of Drew Brees, you think of production and you think of competitiveness. That guy competes on every snap, whether he's throwing it, moving around in the pocket, calling plays, you name it, he knows how to rally a team.
Throwing on first down is Brees. Caught by Snead over the middle. And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. A good safe pass there right off the bat.
That's almost a rhythm play. That's what we like to call it. Get them into rhythm early, something safe, something they're confident about, something they feel good. And once that's completed, then you just keep moving from there because the confidence elevates.
Now Brees throwing on second down. He's going to flip that out to the flat. It's complete. Only a gain of a yard, but that's all they needed, as that's going to move the chains. Brees now on first down. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete. Second down here after the incomplete pass. Brees again here on second, and he rifles one that's intercepted. And some room to maneuver. And he will bring it back. It's an interception return for a Rams touchdown. And the defense could not have written a much better script than that first drive, pick six.
The offense never got a chance to really get oiled up there, did they? But the defense, they certainly got in gear. What a big-time play and a great way for them to start.
And now the offense, they've got to turn things around and figure this out because your backs are on the ground real quickly.
Yeah, usually when you're starting the game getting the ball, 0-0 is the only score you're worried about. Now the second time you get it, you're already down a touchdown.
It's up, it's good, and the Rams take a 7-0 lead. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. On the return, here's Marcus Murphy. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. Out is the Saints offense now as they get ready to take over here. They'll run for the first time with Mark Ingram. And he'll get this up only to about the 33. It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up second down. The defense here for the Rams.
I played college football at the same time as T.J. McDonald's father, Tim. And what a great player he was. T.J. definitely is following in his...
Breeze again here on second, and he rifles one that's intercepted. And some room to maneuver. And he will bring it back. They're now on third and 13. Goff now looks to throw. Finding time. All kinds of time. He's going to find his man. That's Tavon Austin. Now loose football. The ball comes out, and they have
not only a short-term memory, but a whole lot better ball security. Because if they take care of the ball, continue to move it, their chances of scoring some points, they've got to feel pretty good about. They thought they had things moving in the right direction last time. Fumbles, they don't just affect you on offense. They affect your overall team because now your defense has to make that stand up.
One to Gurley. Oh, and he's not going to make it out of the end zone. The push too strong, and that'll be a safety. So this is where a defense can really pin back its ears, bring it all, sell out to stop the run. This time, it'll earn him 2 points.
They definitely guessed right here. A run blitz all the way, and that's a bad feeling for a running back when he knows he's got to at least get it over the goal line. But all he sees
convert here on third and a little more than a yard. And now for the offense, this is play number 11 here on this drive. They come out here in the eye. Again on the ground, again it's Spiller. They'll be marked inches short, no gain on the play, and that's going to lead them to fourth down. Line of scrimmage, the two. They can still get a first down if they just get a yard out of this on fourth and very short. They'll run for it. It's Ingram. And it appears we've got a member of the Rams.
Georgia, I stood on a table and did backflips. Even with the knee injury he suffered his last year there, I thought he was one of the best runners I'd seen come into the game since Adrian Peterson.
On first down, gone. Throwing over the middle, and it's incomplete. He was looking to get it to Kenny Britt that time. And now it's second down. Second and 10, Goff again. On the screen, this is Mason. And he'll be about a full yard shy of the 20 at the 19-yard line. It'll be a gain of 6, and that's going to bring up a third down.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass, looked like it was coming together, looked like there was an opening. Still, ended up with a solid game.
From the gun on third down, Goff. Got a man open, it's Brian Quick. And he's able to get it to the 31, and that's enough for the first. We heard them talk before the game about utilizing the intermediate passing game this week. It works for them there. They move the chains.
And we saw them work on it in practice as well. And most teams take a period at a time to work on different things. They put a couple of periods of work into the intermediate passing game, and now we know exactly why. They got the look that they were seeking, and they were able to take advantage of it.
26 yards on the pickup there. And it'll be first down, Rams.
When I watched Jared Goff on tape at Cal, I saw a guy who wasn't just a dart thrower. You know, a lot of people said, he's perfect for the West Coast offense. I always thought he could do a little bit more, and that was the reason why. He can push it downfield. He has a good, strong arm.
On first down, it's Gurley. It'll go as a gain of 10 there, and the Rams are going to get a first down.
Well, so much for him being bottled up throughout the day. Finally finds a way to break through and get a really nice gain. The defense had felt great about what they had going. Now they've got to turn their attention to getting it back in that direction. Can they bottle him up again? Because I'd say after that run, confidence is pretty high for him.
False start offense. Still first down.
The penalty on first down backs him up 5. It's now first down at 15. They'll run it now out of the gun. Fighting his way down to about the 35-yard line. He'll get three of those penalty yards back here, leaving him with a second and 12.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks, allow other people to make tackles. But when he can make the play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
Now Gurley, and he'll be taken down at the 34. 1 yard officially on the pickup, and it'll leave him with a third and 11. And the offense readies for play number 10 of this series.
Tough day, tough sledding right there, and it's been that way the entire game. Not a whole lot of room to ramble for him.
Yeah, you're right. It's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there. A dump off for Mason. And he picks up the first down yardage as he takes it down to the 16. He goes for 18 there as the drive will continue.
And I know you can't really see it, but that play spells frustration with a capital F for the guys on defense. They covered everyone else. End up going to the running back out of the backfield. And he picks up a backbreaking first down.
Call the intended receiver, Tavon Austin. That'll bring up second down. But just play after play after play on this long drive for the offense. Now whistles and a flag down. I think one of the Rams linemen might have moved.
False start, offense.
Penalty. It's Gurley, and he'll get it here to the 10-yard line. That one good for 12 yards, and just like that, it's third down, and the defense searches for one more stop here after the run on second down. But they brought in an extra defensive back here, so probably not expecting a run on third and three.
A good call.
Goff now looking to throw. Brian Quick, the intended target, and that brings up fourth down.
Without getting beat deep for big passes.
And he slings one that's incomplete. He was looking for Mark Ingram there. And that'll bring up second down. Unable to connect on the first down pass play. Now it's second down. They'll come out in the pistol. Breeze will try again on second down. His pass caught at the four. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, New Orleans. They're dangerous wide receiver. His second touchdown on the season. And once again, the Saints are back out in front.
And while that touchdown does not give them an in.
Second down. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. And this will split the uprights. It's right down the middle. And the lead is back down to three here at 16-13. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll elect not to return this one, so they'll bring it out to the 25 on the touchback. And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission?
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half and wanting more of that. Sure, you've got to go over some of the errors and clean up some things because there's a reason you're down. But overall, I think they want to stay positive, stay up with this team. We're just starting the second half, and we've got the football. Let's go ahead and punch it in, and then we'll take it from there.
See how that recipe works.
And when all else fails as a defender, when you're not there in the coverage, your best friend is exactly what we saw there. A big play shot taken by the offense. Unfortunately, it ended in a big drop.
Back to the air. Goff on second down. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. It's a gain of seven, and that's going to lead to a third down.
They gave up the completion there, but this is what zone defenses count on. Catching the ball and not much run after the catch.
Goff on third down. Got a man. It's his tight end, Lance Kendricks. And he's brought down after a good game. And they're able to convert on third with a solid gain of 23. Now the offense lining up first and 10.
Partner, it's a lot of fun watching the NFL now, isn't it? Because when the big fella runs routes, it used to be when we were kids, he'd run about three different routes, and that was it. Now he can run anything and catch the ball, as we just saw there.
It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
We talk all the time about how important it is to have leverage in blocking. It's also a big part of policing up gaps. Did you move someone out of the A gap? Did you move them out of the B gap in order to create space for your guy to run? In this case, all those gaps were shut down.
Yeah, the movement was defensive, and they got him for a loss. Back-to-back stops make it third and 10. So this is the second consecutive week, as you look at the numbers, that he just doesn't seem to have the
well for the rest of the drive.
Now Breeze throwing on second down. Over the middle, it's Thomas. And the ball is knocked out. And now the Rams have got it going the other way. And they have the football and will take over at the 24-yard line.
He makes so many catches that are so tough, so acrobatic, so difficult, that often surprises me when they actually turn the ball over. You know, when the ball actually comes free. It's amazing sometimes because of what we see them do on so many different plays.
Had the catch, but couldn't control it on the contact.
That was the end result. Sack. Quarterback gets hit.
Big sack on second down. Now the offense needs to convert here on third.
Here we go now. 3-19.
Third and long. It's gone. Surveying the field. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
Third down is a down. Both sides know they absolutely have to win. And the name of the game for the defense is pressure on the quarterback. But pressure on the quarterback with contact, that's how you end up winning it.
And Zuerlein's kick is good. The pickup, and it'll make it a second down. And they're going to speed things up here. On second down, here's Breeze. And oh, not only did he drop it, he dropped it in the end zone.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
Now Breeze. And he's got him. It's caught in the end zone. Touchdown, New Orleans. Their big-bodied receiver, his fourth touchdown on the year. And the Saints have moved out in front. Well, there was a little extra pressure with that one because it was third down. He didn't care. He snagged it with one hand like it was routine.
The key is to make a play in a tough situation. Doesn't matter how. And in this case, one-handed gets it.
Man, it's Austin, and he's going to have a first down as he's brought down at the 44-yard line. So he makes the grab and the chains move forward.
Nice job by the offensive line, giving them time to complete that first down pass.
They come out here in the eye. They go play action here. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football.
Drive it low in order to have the distance, and that usually puts it in jeopardy, gives them a chance to block it, and everyone knows it on the other side. That's when you get your best jumpers on the other side of the field and try and get up and get it.
On first and 10, Goff. His throw incomplete.
I hope I don't sound too rah-rah on that one, but that's the exact right throw. Either your receiver gets it or no one gets it. Give him a lot of credit for being really precise with it.
Got rid of it. No one got it.
On second and 10, gone. That's complete to his tight end. This is Lance Kendricks. Give him 12 yards on that one. It earns him a fresh set of downs.
I know exactly what's going to be said about that play from the defensive perspective.
What's that?
That's why I tell all you guys we need more than one tackler to the ball. He broke the first tackle. Luckily enough, there are more people there to get him down.
Back to throw. Gone. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Cameron Jordan in there to get him, and that's sack number 8 for him on the year.
You know, on these types of plays, we're always looking to assess blame. Okay, where did it break down? Sometimes it's just a great play.
To throw on second down is gone. He has Britt over the middle. And he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48. Short of the sticks after that completion, and now it's third down for this offense. It's gone. Blitz coming, and down he goes. The quarter blitz gets there as he goes down for a loss of 7.
The game plan for any defense is finding ways to make a quarterback uncomfortable in the pocket. When you bring pressure from all angles, you never know who's going to get home. In this case, the left cornerback, right in the face of him, puts him down.
And this one hits at the 1, continues on into the end zone for a touchback. Out onto the field comes New Orleans. Last time out, they had that long 50-plus yard field goal that they missed.
And I'm sure on their sideline, they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try one if we're in that position again? And I would dare say that the answer would be yes. They're going to have a lot of confidence in their kicker. But just to be on the safe side, I'm sure they told their offensive guys, can we get a little bit closer
this
time?
Yeah, get a little closer.
Yeah, you know, I'd rather get in the end zone first and foremost. But if all else fails, less of a field goal attempt for him.
And did he get the feet down? No, they'll say he did not. It's incomplete. And at this stage of the game, time a factor, time on their side as they just try to eke out the final precious moments of this one. Now Breeze on third down. He's got Snead. And he gets it to the 34. Good enough for the first. Time for a break. We're back to see what happens after this. So it's Saints football as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. On the ground with Kadan. And he was able to... And now the Rams are going to halt things as they want a timeout. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. Breeze is looking to throw. And this would have been intercepted if he could have gotten the feet in. Instead, it's incomplete. Boy, that really could have turned this one upside down. Well, interceptions have been a problem in this one. If he could have gotten his feet down here, it would have been another.
Would have been a huge one. They've had a great game taking the ball away. Thought they had another one, just unable to get those cleats inbounds.
And this is going to be incomplete.
Right, let's go ahead and try and get into the body and the mind of the linebackers. Yeah, I know they're bigger and stronger than I ever was, but in this situation, they...
He's back to throw. Looking sideline, incomplete.
It appears that the pressure is affecting him today. Normally, he knows exactly when to get rid of the football, but today, because he's been hit a few times, he's getting rid of it a little bit too quickly.
Here we go. 339! 339!
Goff not a throw. And, oh, It's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
And that one, it's going to hurt big time. You're in the two-minute drill trying to get your guys down the field, and it's looking like they're going to go up just short, as this is definitely not his best throw. And it'll wind up being intercepted.
Down to a knee here. The defense still with a couple of timeouts. We'll see if they want to use them. And the Rams are going to go ahead and take another timeout. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll take this up only to about his 18-yard line. Now hang on here. Timeout called. Timeout called by the defense. That'll be their third and final stoppage here as we step aside. So third and seven and an extra defensive back on the field here.
Definitely want to play coverage here.
Charles, I think when the schedule comes out, all teams, no matter where they're predicted to finish, talk about protecting your home turf. They were able to do that here in this one.
Similar to a tennis match, right? Not letting them break your serve. That way you hold on to it. They got it done, and they feel very good about that victory.